गुड इवनिंग टू एवरीवन. टुडे वी हैव टू मोर कंफर्म केसेस ऑफ टू पीपल हु ट्रैवल फ्रॉम मुंबई बाय रोड, बट वी ऑल्सो हैव 9 क्योर केसेस. सो आउट ऑफ द फर्स्ट लॉट ऑफ पेशेंट्स हु हैड बिकम पॉजिटिव, वी हैव डन देयर टेस्ट ट्वाइस ओवर एंड देयरफॉर टुडे वी हैव डिस्चार्ज देम. 9 क्योर केसेस. 9 of these people have been kept under our institutional quarantine for 7 more days, and then the same protocol that we followed last time. After 7 days, they will be allowed to go home for 7 more days of home quarantine. So our total number of active cases comes down to 38. Today we sent 503 samples for testing. We received 515 reports. We are still awaiting 27 reports. Suspects under hospital isolation are 3. Interstate domestic travelers quarantined are 409 and travelers in facility quarantine are 247. Total, there are currently 873 quarantined persons, out of which 586 are seafarers. Regarding the board exams, today we had both the 10th and the 12th. In the 10th standard exam, we had 1,951 candidates who appeared, and for the 12th standard exam, we had 1,392 candidates who appeared.
Hi, good evening. And today we had planned for 6 trains to UP, as I disclosed yesterday. We have already sent 3 trains. One train was sent to Deoria, UP, another to Pratapgarh, and third one to Mau, which that has just left. In all the 3 trains, in each train 1628 passengers have gone. So total 4884 passengers have left for UP today. 3 more trains are planned in the day. 2 will go from north district and 1 from south. 2 in north will go from Karmali and 1 from south will go from Madgaon. So far the total number of people who has left Goa is 43,794, and who have come is 4,075. Today there were another set batch of seafarer who came from South Africa. They landed at Mumbai. In the morning we sent the bus so that we can directly pick from them from the airport itself. So these 57 passengers, seafarers, who came from South Africa, out of them 12 are actually scientists who were on Antarctica scientific mission, and they have come to Mumbai, and from Mumbai we have brought them here. They are about to reach in few hours to Goa. Total till now 18 trains have left, and 4 flights have come, including this one at Mumbai, by which we have brought these many seafarers. Additional number of violations, yesterday we noted 627 violations. Out of them, mask challans were 538 and 86 spitting cases. I'll also brief, till now I have not shared the number, but total arrests so far made since the lockdown has begun is 1404, and total FIR registered till 4 p.m. today are 771, and total vehicle seized is 486. And yesterday one question was raised regarding the safety precaution buses also. I want to clarify that in KTCL buses we are maintaining up 50% standard till now, and all buses are externally sanitized using the sodium hypochlorite, and inside they are using Lysol solution. Thermal guns have been provided in the buses, and there is a compulsory mask is being ensured. Even for private buses, we have, SEC has asked the director transport to strictly monitor their movement and ensure the necessary safety precautions. Thank you.
But who is monitoring these private buses?
We have issued the direction to the, because they issue the permit, so it is their responsibility. They have to monitor that they are running as per the law.
Yes, those who have recovered in this first lot, sorry, who has asked that question? I guess. Yes, they are all asymptomatic. Yes.
And these new two cases, what is their travel history?
Their travel history is they came in a bus from Mumbai. Sorry, these are individual travelers. They came separately on their own. There is one lady and one gentleman. They came separately. They have come in their own transport.
Ma'am, there is news that one constable or his relative have tested positive in Kalamkot police station.
This news is unconfirmed and absolutely this information is wrong. About what? Sorry.
SSC exams.
See, from
main subjects would start from tomorrow.
Yes. From day one, we are maintaining our strict abidance by the conditions laid down by the Ministry of Home Affairs. And we have given that commitment and we are keeping to that commitment. Whatever measures we are taking, I've already shared with you. We are sticking to that. Yes, when there are a larger number of students, naturally we have to be better equipped. We are definitely better equipped and we can manage the numbers.
The other thing is that the new MHA guidelines have come as far as overseas goings and all. So any new preparations for them once they start coming in there?
The protocol will be specified in the OCI, I'm sure talking about those guidelines issued by MHA regarding OCI. So the SOPs for that will definitely be issued by the ministry and we will follow by them.
Madam, just coming back to my colleague's question, those who have arrived from Mumbai too, but
yes.
Are they Goans?
See, whoever is coming into Goa by road has to upload their documents online. You're aware that there is an e-pass system which is run by both the collectors. They have to upload their documents showing that they have a residence proof of being in Goa. Only after that the applications are processed.
Even though there is a huge amount of migrants who have returned back to their states, yesterday there were some photos which were viral, going viral in Margao. A huge crowd had gathered.
Yes.
So at that time,
I have confirmed from the collector, as I told you yesterday, there were huge number of people from UP. They want to go back to their home as early as possible, and that's why we prepare plan for 6 trains today, and we have plan again a large number of trains tomorrow. But we that I can share only after confirmation whether railway will be able to provide that many trains or not. I believe, and as a collector has confirmed, we have sufficient facility in our shelter home also, but they come in more in number once they get information that their friend is going. But today, as I said, 4,884 people have left, and same number of people will leave in another up to 10 p.m. From Karmali, two trains are leaving at 7 p.m. one, and another is at 9 p.m. So we believe with this large number of people going out, that that crowd and the pressure will come down. Still we have a number of people from UP, and we hope that the situation will improve. Collector has confirmed that they are taking due care, and the sufficient facility, food, lodging is available in the nearby shelter homes. That nearby shelter home is only 500 meter away from there, from the railway station, and so they can take care of them. But it is a slight anxiety that people want to board as early as possible. Everybody wants to be first in the train. I hope with the today 6 train leaving, the situation will improve it drastically.
Ma'am, today the CCP mayor sees some tobacco products and warned the people, actually the shop owners about it. There is a tobacco ban in Goa. So, y'all have started finding the people, what Mr. Sanjay Kumar said. Is there anything, any mechanism now that to check that there is no tobacco sale throughout Goa like that?
You see, what we are doing is basically implementing our Goa Anti-Spitting Act, which you are aware of. That is one thing that we are implementing. And then smoking is prohibited under the CODPA Act. These are the two acts that we are enforcing. So, all actions like before continue under these two legislations. So that action is continuing. Secretary Revenue every day shares with you also the violations under the Anti-Spitting Act. CODPA Act, we have always been, for that matter, even Anti-Spitting Act has been.
But despite this, the sale of tobacco and all these products is still rampant.
Whatever is there stipulated by law is being adhered to. It is being implemented. Yes.
Now the passengers by plane will arrive in Goa. whether government has proposed antibody testing or rapid testing at airport.
Regarding the arrival of passengers, domestic passengers by air, we are still awaiting SOPs and guidelines from the central government. We are expecting that very soon we will be receiving those. So accordingly, we will be moving forward.
Is there in our state government can seek the documents of who are traveling from other states without any reason? Can
you mean the air passengers?
Air and both, plane and ship.
Documents, we get a list, both the, I think Secretary Reddy would be in a better position to explain this.
As per the current SOP, railways and flight operation both are central government subjects. So they have made the SOP. They have mandated it that these lists will be shared with the state governments. But as far as the current SOP, they have not mandated that reasons will be asked from the people who are traveling in the flights and in the trains. So what we took is we ramped up our testing facilities. We tried to make more teams so that we can test them as far as we can. And as you know, the CM, Honorable CM, has already written a letter to Government of India regarding the running of rail services, especially the terminating train. But ultimately, these two subjects, as I said, are of central government, and whatever central government protocol or direction will be, will abide by them. I shared with you that on these things, the national protocol they have issued, Government of India, they have prescribed very long step by step what has to be done, and the airlines and the Ministry of Civil Aviation, they will be following these guidelines, including all airports, and based on that, whatever list will be shared with us, we are awaiting. We will be taking our precautionary measures.
Roughly, whenever you talk about these trains which are coming in South Goa, what is the total number of passengers that come inside, and in the way you all have to do this testing?
By, if you are asking by train, so far, when train have started, we have received 777 passengers, including from Rajdhani, where we have tested all of them. And in the same trains, 1,893 people have departed also.
Is it within that same day, or it took time?
No, this train came on different days. But this is the total so far, that 777 passengers have arrived in Goa by these trains.
And how many have left?
1,893 have departed by these trains.
Ma'am, you said that Goa is the only state which test each and every person who comes inside. So same will be followed for the air traffic after the 25th?
As we have both already mentioned, we are expecting detailed guidelines and SOPs from the central government. We will await those.
Mr. Kumar, can you just clarify, has the standards center stopped you from charging the people whom you are testing and providing the accommodation for coming from out?
No, we have not received any such stoppage order.
But still, the state government can do it, no?
So we are doing it. We are testing, and we are.
We are charging rupees 2,000 for every test that we are doing.
Every person that comes through road as well as the railways.
Right? Right now, every person coming by air and by train, we are charging.
This 2,000 includes accommodation for one day.
We are taking 2,000 for testing. Their accommodation, we are not taking anything separate. Air passengers anyways have to have their own paid quarantine.
Yes.
Train, we have not taken anything separate for accommodation. We are taking only 2,000.
Even for these 57 people who have come by from Mumbai, or who are coming, their facilities have been tied up. Their hotels, paid quarantine have been tied up by their companies.
They will be tested.
Yes.
Three more samples have been sent for confirmatory test. That is true.
That is right. Three samples are awaiting confirmation. Yes. All right.
Thank you.
Have you identified any private lab after the SRL being
Yes, a couple of labs have approached us. They have not told us exactly when they will start operation. But yes, the process is underway.
And just one more thing. The three patients who were tested positive by SRL and then they turned out to be negative, those were added in your tally, right?
So yes, definitely yes.
So then after they proved to be negative,
yes,
then
we are following the same protocol.
But that their number, I mean, that those numbers we need after split.
Whenever we test them, we follow the same protocol like in every other patient. We test them, and when they test negative twice, then we declare them as cured. Yes, but the numbers won't change. Naturally, they have been added to our tally and they have been admitted in COVID hospital. So, got the point. Thank you.
Can you share one information about that COVID fund, state fund? What is the contribution as of today? How many expenditure from that fund?
I can say that about 9 crore have been received in that fund the last time, few days ago when I checked it, and there is about 4 crore of expenditure has been done, majorly on especially KTC buses which we have hired for special facilities, and relief material, the ration which we have distributed to the standard laborers.
Okay, thank you.